Hello everyone. In the previous video, we have discussed what are the boundary layer equations. And we finally concluded that the system is nonlinear and hence we get approximate solutions to the system by using a method called momentum integral method. So what is this momentum integral method? So I'll just give you a very brief overview of what that method is. Like first, from the V momentum equation, this dou P prime by dou Y prime is zero, which means pressure is constant across the boundary layer. So this implies that dou P by dou X outside the boundary layer should be equal to dou P by dou X inside the boundary layer. Now in free stream, we know that U dou U by dou X is minus 1 by rho dou P by dou X. Thus, we can say that this U dou U by dou X equal to minus 1 by rho dou P by dou X everywhere. Now, how we got this equation means from the U momentum equation, you can say that outside the boundary layer, mu is 0. So, you can equate this to 0. And then mu dou U by dou Y, this also you can equate this. Sorry, U dou U by dou Y, you can also equate this to 0. And then from 1, you can write this as U dou U by dou X plus V dou U by dou Y as capital U dou capital U by dou X plus mu dou U square by dou Y square. If you integrate this from 0 to H, where H is some arbitrary height about the surface, and after doing some algebra and simplifications, you will get the final momentum integral equation as this. Integral from 0 to H, dou by dou X of U into capital U minus small u dy, plus dou u by dou x into integral from 0 to x u minus u dy equal to tau w by rho. Now, these two terms have specific meaning. One term relates to the momentum deficit, and other term relates to the mass deficit, which is due to the deceleration caused by the boundary layer. So, let us, in a general sense, let us discuss more about those two terms. One is the displacement thickness. Displacement thickness is the distance by which the surface needs to be shifted in y direction in an inviscid flow to produce same mass flux deficit as in the boundary layer. That is, say the boundary layer thickness is delta here. And say the flow has some distribution like this. Finally, at delta, you will get it as u. Strictly speaking, 0.99 u, but I can approximate that as u. So I'll get this is for the viscous case. For inviscid case, by how much distance delta star should I move this plate up so that I'll get the same mass flux deficit, which is the area, this area and this area, they should be the same, which is integral from 0 to delta, rho into capital U minus small u dy is equal to rho u delta star. So I can get delta star as integral from 0 to delta, 1 minus u by capital U dy. This is one important formula. Similarly, we define momentum thickness as distance by which a surface needs to be shifted in y direction to produce the same momentum flux deficit. So again, if I use the definition, I'll get my momentum thickness as like this. I define shape factor h as delta star by theta. So finally, this equation becomes dou theta by dou x plus 2 times 2 plus delta star by theta into theta by u dou u by dou x equal to tau w by rho u square. This is also one important equation. Using these three equations, we can find the value of delta as a function of x. An example of that is a laminar flow model, where you will find the laminar flow boundary layer thickness as some delta is equal to some approximately phi by root rex. We'll come back to this later, but this is like we'll basically use this method. So in general, how we proceed is like we first find this u, or the ideal solution to calculate the pressure gradients in U. And then we perform boundary layer calculations to find delta star and then add the computed displacement thickness to produce a new displacement surface to be used in recomputing gradients, and iterate this few times till convergence. But this may not work if boundary layer is close to the boundary layer separation point. But strictly speaking, for problem solving in examinations, this equation, and this equation, these three equations are more than sufficient for you. Okay, thank you.